Hey everyone, in this video, I want to talk about some of my strategies of how I graduated with a 4.0 in chemical engineering. The techniques that I will mention in this video should be applicable no matter what your field of study is though. But before we begin, I just want to preface this video by saying don't put too much pressure on yourself. Yes, getting a good GPA in school is great, but be sure to take some time to enjoy yourself and your time in school, with friends, relaxing, whatever that may be, as getting burnt out is incredibly common in engineering. And I want to see all of you succeed, not just in school, but in your future careers as well. The largest problem faced by college students, speaking from my experience in engineering, is just the pure amount of work to complete. Between tests, assignments, classes, labs, maintaining a social life, potentially a part-time job, there just isn't enough hours in the day. So, let's get into some techniques that will get you a high GPA while studying for less time. Let's just go through my top 4 methods to get your GPA to skyrocket. My first piece of advice to anyone in engineering that wants to excel and get great grades is to spread out their assignments. Think about how you currently handle your assignments. Are you always feeling behind, failing to turn them in, or completing assignments at the last minute? Well, think about this. Let's just say we get an assignment with 6 questions on it. And let's say that we have about 10 days to complete it. We could think, hey, only 6 questions, that's easy. I'll just hammer that out on Saturday, day 9. Well, the problem with this thought process is that your understanding of the material may increase during that one small session, but it doesn't really help come test day. It has been shown in studies that a more efficient way of memorizing material and understanding that material better is to look at that material and try to understand it over a number of days rather than hours. So, let's apply this knowledge to how we study. So now, instead of completing our assignment in a single day, let's consider completing 1 question a day from our assignment. Every day, we spend a short amount of time to study and complete just 1 question, and solely focused on that 1 question. Then, after that 1 question, you're done with that class for the day. As I previously mentioned, studies show that daily repetition in this manner will help you better remember and really understand how you completed the questions come test day. In addition to this great benefit, you'll also have time to attend your teacher's office hours and discuss your thought process with your teachers or classmates, and you'll actually understand the content much better than panicking and try to Google the answers the night before. The second piece of advice I have is to plan out everything to the best of your ability. The way I began every semester in college is going through all of my course outlines and highlighting all the key dates. So, all test dates, due dates, assignments, labs, highlight everything. Then you're going to take all these dates and put them in your Google Calendar, an agenda, reminders in your phone, or really anything that will remind you in advance that you have something important coming up. This will give you a constant reminder of what is going to be due soon, and nothing will come as a surprise to you throughout the semester. This peace of mind is also great for mental health, and will make you feel much more in control and not drowning in your studies. Thirdly, I will highly recommend that you digitalize your notes. So, this could be done in one of 2 ways. Firstly, if you're using an iPad or some other tablet, this is easy as your notes are already digitalized. Secondly, if you use paper and a pencil or pen, just scan your notes at the end of each week or day. You may say, hey, but that's going to be a lot of work. Well, it might take a few minutes, but there are a few apps such as GoodNotes that when you scan your documents, it can recognize your handwriting. This has saved me tons of time flipping through old notebooks trying to find one piece of information. All I need to do now is go find and search for my term that I'm looking for, and it'll give me the page of interest. Even better, when you're finally done school, someday, you probably won't want 100 pounds of engineering notes stashed away. So, by digitalizing your notes, you can ensure that you always have them readily available. My last piece of advice is 1 week before every test that you have, create a 1-page cheat sheet. Depending on the quantity of material covered on the test, you may only need half a page or 2 pages. The idea here is to write down everything that we think is important on this cheat sheet. Now, we're not going to actually bring this cheat sheet into the test with us, unless we're allowed to. The idea here is that we have less room on our page than we actually need. Through such, we learn to prioritize what topics are most important and help ourselves to get a better understanding of how the material relates within itself. Through completing a cheat sheet in this manner, I will guarantee you that it will help you understand the material before any big test. Finally, I just want to reiterate what I said at the beginning of the video. Yes, good grades are important, so when we're achieving those high grades, let's be as efficient as possible so we have more time to do the things that relax us and make us happy. Just remember this, school isn't a competition. There are tons and tons of students that graduated with low GPAs, no internships, that went on to be incredibly successful. Continually learn new skills where you can. Learn to sell yourself to future employers, and just aim to do your best so that no matter what happens, at least you can be proud of yourself for trying. Thank you everyone for checking out this video, and I hope that there was at least one tip that you were able to take from this video that can help you succeed in school. If you guys have any tips on how to excel in school, leave a comment down below for others to try. If you enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our Patreon page to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.